Wasabicats, this is Jay ng Team Basic Gunpla at ang Wasabi Toys para sa naubos yung aking hininga para sa another unboxing video. At for today's unboxing video, it's going to be big, it's going to be red, it's going to be the Gundam Astray Red Frame Kai. So I have this kit for quite a long time na. This is actually owned by a very good friend of mine, Mr. Marc. So rich Chua. Mr. Marc, so rich Chua. Pakita mo na lang yung kit at i-unbox natin dahil hindi ko na alam kung anong laman ito. At this kit was released last 2018, if I confirm natin. Yes, this was released last 2018, so it's been quite a long time na, no? So never ko pa siya na-open dahil so, ang gawin na natin, let's unbox it together. Kaya, let's unbox and let's go to the box. Sa front ng box, makikita natin ang photo ni Red Frame. Hawak kanyang, ang kanyang super, super big tactical sword. Yan, nagbabi natin camera. At sa kabilang side naman, so I'm not sure if ano ba talaga yung front, if it's that one or this one. But if I have to decide, if I have to choose, mas maganda to for me itong side na to, no? Hawak yung kanyang dalawang Gerbera Straight at dalawang katana. Hawak ang kanyang dalawang katana. Sa pataas naman, it's just the name Gundam Astray Red Frame. It's a perfect grade, of course. Sa kabilang side is yung mga poses na pwede nyong gawin. So the long awaited perfect grade Gundam Astray Red Frame Kai, the iconic tactical arms. Yes, tama ako, tactical arms ang tawag doon. And ito yung mga poses na pwede nyong gawin. Life form, nasa likod niya yung tactical arms. Okay, so para siyang wings. And ito naman ang delta form, in which para sa bang delta form, let's feed it together. A form resembling an inverted triangle. Ah, okay nga, naging triangle nga sa likod niya. On the mobile suit's back, the unraveling of the next generation Voyager Lumiere propulsion system. Ah, okay, so para siyang propulsion system pag ganyang position. So, mabibili siya or something like that. Next is the work form. Okay, so napapansin nyo, binabago lang madalas is yung tactical arm. So, iba't iba pala ang purpose niya. So, do forgive me if I'm not familiar with the manga or the series. I need to watch or read this pala. Mukhang maganda siya. Yung work form, kasi ang pagkakalam ko is nasa jump field yung pilot nito, si Lou. Forgot the name. Again, sorry sa mga Red Frame fans natin, no? I promise to research more sa series na to, sa Seed. I do like Seed, no? Sa series, no? For me, napakaganda ng kanyang story. I really like Kira. And ang pag-progress ng kanyang pagiging new type. Ano nga ba yung tawag sa nila? Anyway, balik tayo sa position, sa mga poses. Yung sword form, so ayun na. So, ayun, ang purpose niya is a big, super big sword. At isa naman is yung arrow form. Ano yung bala nito? A form resembling a large bow that fires. Oh, okay. So, ang bala niya ay beam arrow. So, napaka multi-purpose pala talaga ng tactical arms niya. Ang daming pwedeng gawin. Wow. At mukhang marami na yung parts. At sa kabilang side, oh, teka, nakaikot na tayo dyan. And sa kabila, this one, yun! So, pag nabuo niyo na siya, ito yung mga pwede niyong gawing pose. Ito, maganda yung ganito lang. Front. Okay, could actually see all those details. At yung dalawang sword. Ito yung pinaka-selling point ito. Dalawang katana. Finger barrel straight. At yung likod. Napaka-hanep. Napaka-hanep. So, what else? Oh, ang tawag pala dito is V-form. Kasi parang V niya sa likod niya. So, V-form, okay. And what else? Gerbera Straight and Tiger Pierce. So, magkaiba ng pangalan yung sword? Ganun ba? two katanas. Oh, okay, tama. Two katanas, the Gerbera Strait and the Tiger Pierce are, wow, included. Plated editions of the Gerbera Strait and the Tiger Pierce are included. They are each engraved with the Kiku, Ichimonji, tama ba, and Kotetsu on their tanks. From their grip forms to the hammers on their blades. Wow! Alright, may pangalan pala sila. Again, hindi ako familiar kaya pagpasensya nyo na. Details! Looking at the details, yung ano pala ang lalagyan ng sword, napaka-detalyado na. And lightning. Yup, may light siya. Let's see if kasamang LED. Siya ba man LED? May nakalagay ba dito? The head camera eyes can be lit up using a built-in light unit. Yun, may kasamang LED. At bibilan na lang natin ang battery. So, battery na lang kulang. So, it uses the CR1-220 Sol Zebretli. Isang piraso lang. At, and, special markings unique to the plastic model kit are included. I do hope na water slide ang kasama nito. But, then again, wishful thinking na water slide nga. So, ano bang inintay natin? Let's open this baby up! And, it's a typical box. Yeah, may special effects tayo. It's a typical box na merong locking hinge sa gilid. No? Alam naman natin pag yung mga box ng gunpies may handle. It is special and it's super, well, it's not that heavy. It's still, it is heavy. Dahil sa dami ng parts niya. O yan, so buksan na natin, no? So, unlock na natin. I-unlock. Yun, oop! Nandito pala yung isang puro. Nasa loob pala. Alright, so, isa pang photo sa loob. Ito, hindi ko alam yung sabihin, baka Kai. Kai means, kindly inform me. And, comment na lang sa video natin kung ano yung sabihin ng character na to. I don't know. So, yun! Let's open! At, oh, okay. Patagilid. So, we have to put this aside, on its side na para mabuksan. And, let's drop the camera first. Hold on, guys. Ayan. Pakita eh. I'm wearing my short shorts. So anyway, yan. At ang daming parts. Oh my goodness. Yan. So yan. The bullet. At teka, nakita yung manual. Oh, imangka pa lang ganyan. Manual. Stick. This one is stick. I'm not sure if this is sticker or yung sa unicorn na perfect grape. So let's browse through muna sa manual before we get the runners from the box. So sa likod ng manual, there's ang photo ni Red Frame Kai. That's on the back. On the front, I think this is the one on the side na nakapost yung let's just scroll again. Let's check again. Kanyang Delta. That is the Delta form post na may sound, may effects daw. Hindi na sa box. Anyway, let's look at the manual sa first page at makikita natin ang sangkatutak na runners. It's 1, 2, 3 pages of all the runners that is included on the kit. At yung mga, wait, this is the first ah. Yung nakita na ngayon sa manual. So you need, siyempre, kailangan ng side cutter. Switch to camera. Yan. Kati na side cutter at ng tawag sa ganito. Tweezer. So yan, oh, may tweezer na tayo. Hindi ba lang ako nagagalit sa tweezer. Baka sa markings. Bundles, more parts, and stickers. Oh, yun na. It's a given. It has stickers, not water slides. Anyway, let's start. And also, you guys need to have screwdrivers din. Usually kasi meron talaga sa mga perfect grade natin ang kailangan i-screw sa mga joints kasi to, you know, just to be safe na hindi ba disassemble habang ginagawin ng post yung model kit. So, let's count the runners. Ilan ba yung runners ito? Let's see. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, because may 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. Wow, nasa 30 na tayo. 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40. 41. So, ito na yung times ko na. What's 41? Dalawang page. 41, tama ba? Di ba ako nag-skip? 41, wow! 41, 42, 43, 40, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50, 51, 52, 53, 54, 55, 56, 57, plus yung runners pa ng stand. So that's, let's get, sabi mo na natin, no? 57, 58, 59, and that is 60 runners in total. Wow! And also, we have the LED, internal LED. So it does not use na yun yung mga pilog na built-in na LED na. You have to assemble the LED manually. Just like the older Perfect Wave kits na nakalabas yung LED niya, yung springs, yung contacts, you have to assemble that separately. So, it also has some die-cast parts, so there are steel or metal parts. I'm not sure if what this part is for. Two. So, baka sa ano to. I think, I'm guessing this is for the knee. And the knee parts, this, I'm not sure. My protection tubes and the screws. Rubber stickers. Whoa, I'm curious where I will be putting those. Rubbers. Wait. It says here, it has water slide decals. Oh my God. Thank you so much, Bandai. Water slide decals. We'll have to look at those later. And sa manual. Okay. Wow. Water slide. Gulta ko dun. You can expect a lot of stickers. Usual, perfect grade na manual. So, nakalagay na dito yung mga runners na kailangan nyo to build the specific part. So, ano ba itong part na to? This is the feet. Wow. A whole page for a feet. Nice. Next is the legs. So, ayun yung mga parts na kailangan nyo. Mm-hmm. What else? Okay. So, we have 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 pages for the legs only. And for the torso, or for the hip, so crutch. You have two pages for that part. Sa chest naman, sa upper body niya, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, 5 pages for the body, the upper body. And sa head, this is actually what I'm curious, no? Sa head niya. Paano ikakabit yung yun na yung mga LED mo. So, it's always there na hindi siya nakatanggal. Kaya nakakabit yung LED. So, there are two pages. Well, 1.5. Since kalati na yung dito. And, that's it, no? Weapons na tapos. Oh, wait, wala pa yung arms. Then, there's the beam rifle. This one page. At, yung dalawang katana. I'm excited to see this. Pag-check natin later. So, yun yung mga details siya, nakihiwalay talaga pala. Wow, nice, very nice. So, Gundam Astray at Tiger Pierce, magkaiba yung pattern ng blade o yung hasa. Yung kanyang, yung hasa, I'm not sure anong sa English to. Beware of the tip, kasi baka masugatan daw kayo kasi matalim siya. It would be nice sana if bakal talaga to. No? Pero syempre, that would add to the cost. I do think na naglabas yata ng third party manufacturers ng bakal talaga for this specific kit. I'm not sure pero parang may nakita ko somewhere sa Facebook na nagpost noon. So ito yung kanyang hilt. Hilt na tawag dito. God, nakalimutan ko na yung tawag sa mga parts ng sword. Pati yung sa Tiger Pierce at Your Barrel Straight. So ito yung sinasabi kanina, nakasulat talaga yung name ng mga katana. Nice. Nice. Very nice, Bandai. At may cover naman pala yung gift kasi ba masugatan daw kanya.
Meow.
At next RD. Wow, I'm forgetting names na already, no? Ano nga matawag sa lalagyan ng sword? Anyway, yun siya. Just, wala. That is still a lot of parts for the swords, container. And the shield naman, okay. The shield has advantage only. But still, madaming parts. Mukhang madaming parts yung shield. Ito yung pinagusto kong i-build sa mga, sa concept shield. Minsan yun, actually, yung nauna ko at weapons. At ang hinuhuli ko parati is yung legs. Wow! Ito na. Color locate, marking location sa water slide. Wow, water slide. Color guide, if you would like to paint. Ano naman yung guide niya. So, deep red. Body part is 100% red. So, it's up to you kung gusto nyo baguhin yung tone, yung shade ng red, at ibang tone ng red na gagamitin nyo. But from it, I think this is bloody red. At looking at the video at yung nasa manual, almost the same talaga yung color sa camera rin. So, nice one, Samsung. Mm-hmm. Yung tactical arms na is napaka-kick-ass tingnan talaga. Ang ganda. Sana may nabibiling ano nito, third party rin. O maglabas si Bandai na separately na mabibili nyo. Tapos dalawa, wow, that would be nice. And then SD, the arms, shoulders I mean, pati sa loob may detail, so let's check that later sa runners. What else? So for the actual arms, we have a lot of runners that you would be using. So this is a 3 pages for the arms. Since this one is for the weapons placement lang naman. Hindi siya sa actual parts, no? Sa assembly. So this is for what is this for? Sa hip. Dito nilalagay yung Tiger Pierce at Rivera Street. So walang direction if left or right. So I guess you will be, it's up to you to choose. And also for the hands pala, it has the manipulator hands. Sana matibay dahil ilan lang kapag post kasi changing from using tactical arms and swords beam rifle, so madaling lumawag sa shield. And what else sa shield? Okay, yung rubber kanina nasa manual para dito pala. Okay, ang galing galing ni Bandai, naisip pa nila yung parang maingatan. dito na yung tactical arms. Dalawa pala talaga. Dalawa ba? Isa lang. Tactical arms 2. L sword 4. L sword 4. Ano yung sabi ng L sword form? Do inform me. Sana. Inform us. No? Post yung sa comment kung ano yung L form. Laser form ba yun? Ang daming parts. Teka, hindi ko nabilang yung page. Balikan natin. For the tactical arms, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 pages for the tactical arms alone, no? Dami. Ang daming page na. And, pati yung stand, nandito na rin yung procedure and how you build the stand. Siyempre, hindi mamawala yan. At pati yung mga poses na pwede nyo gawin ay yung sword form. Let's look at that. So, may mga pegs kayo kailangan gawin. The longest parts. Ilalagay nyo sa stand. Next is the sword form. So, yung directions ng tactical arms sa palit-palit is nandito rin. Siyempre, manghuhula tayo if wala. Long arrow form. Nice one. Diba? Ang dami. Ang galing. Short arrow form. Short move. Napagpapanan. Pwede na yun si Delta. I think this is for the Delta. Hindi po yung V-form pala yan. Yung Delta yung isa. I'm not sure how to pronounce this correctly. The V-form, maganda we could touch V-form. Did I pronounce that correctly? I'm not sure. Oh, and ito yung Delta form. Maganda we could touch V-form or 2 Delta form. 2 Delta form siya. So, ayan. mukha namang ano eh, ang directions niya. Mukha namang let's put some light there. Mukha namang malinaw, so madali niyo makafollow to. So delta form to work form. Okay. So you have to transform it first to a form bago pumunta sa isa pang form. So that's medyo confusing. So dapat yung talaga tingnan yung manual. Para tama, tama yung pagkagawa. So all in all, we have 43 pages sa manual. That is quite a lot for a perfect grade. So I'm not sure if mayroon pang kits na mas madaming pages. Sa unicorn kasi hindi ko matandaan eh. Although I built a couple of it already. Alam ko makapal din yung manual na. So, let's go to the runners. Here are the runners. Yan, tinanggal ko na sa box. Kasi ang hirap, ilagay sa lamesa dahil sobrang laki. Okay, so let's start with this one. Siyempre, yung pinakauna kong nakita are these two. Ito yung Tiger Pierce at Reverb Astray. So, ano na, may protection pa na binigilagay talaga si Bantay. Nice. So, these are rubber. So, sabi na nalagay. May nakilagay mo kanina sa sabi doon sa manual, may nakalagay na name sa plate. So, I'm not going to open this kasi hindi atin yung kit. So, nandun sa kabilang side nitong blade na to. At pinarangan yung name na yan. So, this one, let's see if makikita natin. Yes! Kita. So, kita nyo ba? Yan. So, ito yung, I'm not sure if this is the reverse rate or the Tiger Pierce. It does not say here. So, 2009 pa to. So, I guess this is, it's actually the same blade that was used on the previous red frame na perfect grade. But this one, let's see, same day date. It's 2009 as well. Okay. Hindi ko kasi matandaan yung previous perfect grade noon. If, alam ko kasi Gerbera State lang talaga yung kasama niya eh. Still, do correct me if I'm wrong. At medyo matagal lang sila. So, yan. I think this is the selling point of this kit. Itong dalawang blade na to. Ano ba? Magkaiba talaga ng... not sure if kita sa camera yung kanyang parang fake na hasa. Yan. So, ito medyo wavy na medyo magkakalayo. This one, medyo sharp yung pagkaka-wave niya. So, para siyang mountains. Far away mountains. No? Okay, so itabi muna natin itong dalawa. And let's go to the other runner. Sa mga red parts niya, it's deep red. Ba? No. Personally, if you ask me, it's not that red. I'm not sure if that's a light or not. But ayun no. Akala ko talaga hiniwalay na ni Bandai itong ano, details. Sa arms yata, at sa shoulders eh. It would be nice sana na magkaiwala ito. At para hindi kayo mahirapan mag-detail. Still, maganda pa rin kasi detalyado siya. This is the runner H. I'll be posting as the photos of each runner. Dami nito. Well, not all na lang no, sa end of the video natin para makita nyo talaga na mas malinaw. Not all ah. Gusto ko nang tingnan talaga makita is yung water slide eh. So, naka-excited. This is the runner D. Ito yung white. Okay, so it's the usual white that Bandai uses. But looking at the plastic, it's not that shiny. It's, for me, it's a good one. It's a good thing. Dahil ayaw ko talaga ng shiny na bare plastic. So I don't wash this eh. Matic runner. Primer talaga ako, no? Minsan kasi, sabi na, dapat nyo daw hugasan ng joy. Pwede siguro pagkatapos nyo magliha, pero never pa kasi ako na-experience na tanggal yung primer. Na hindi ko naman hinugasan kasi talaga ang runner. So, depende na siguro siya sa primer na gamit nyo o sa pagkakatimpla nyo. So, this one is the rubber parts. This is, I'm not sure if this is, what is this for? Parang rubber sa chinelas. Yon, next, this runner. Yun, detalyado pa rin siya. I think this is for the shoulders again. Ayun yung details niya. No? Ayun, pwede kayo mag-masking dito at ihwala yung part sa loob, gawin yung black. Medyo madali lang kasi kwadrado naman. At yun yung ibang screws. Mm-hmm. Yes, the details are there pa rin. Good job, Bandai. At yung black naman na runner, this is for the tactical arms. It's not that black. I think I could compare this blackness to NATO black ng Tamiya, if you're familiar with NATO black. Para siyang NATO black na. It's not black talaga, no? It's a deep black. It's light. So may mga swirl marks pa na pagkakamold niya nasa blihahin. Next is the green led part. So nasa tactical arms niya itong part na to, or sa legs, I'm not sure, or sa shield, kasi merong shield part ng shield dito. Ayan. So it's not that green eh. Tama ba, light green yata yung usual nakikita ko, but this one it's hindi siya deep green, hindi siya light green. I think it's in the sits in the middle. Ayan. And next runner, tagal naman ng water slide, hindi natin makita. Huwaya magpakita. Still, ito yung red sa tactical arms. Let's put it that way, there. And ito na yung, hindi ko pa rin maalala. Oh my god, hindi ko pa rin maalala kung ano tawag sa lalagyan ng sword. Nakakainis. Oh, I mean pala ito, si Low ba? Ano? Ay guys, sorry talaga. Mark Emil. Kung pwede ka nang tanungin sana, mabilis eh. Because you're a red frame fanboy. Kain siya. Para sa ito bro. Sisiu sa ito sa pagpinturaan mo. Mark Emil, you. Belated happy birthday bro. I hope you have a good one. So yan, so apat. Oh, dalawa rin. Since dalawa yung, ano niya, dalawa yung talagyan. Dalawa rin yung character na kasama niya. Wow, nice. Dalawa rin yung nakupo. Pinakita nakupo. Ayun. So dalawa. Two of each. Nice. Very good. Ayun, ganang bonus yun ah. And ito, some parts pa rin sa shield. Ah, sa sword. Sa lalagyan ng sword. Ayan. And yung shield na, ito yun na, hindi siya talaga black, no, NATO black. And ang tagal naman na, water slide, nasaan ka na water slide, gusto kita makita. Let's put it there for now. Oh, I think I saw another shade of red. This one is not that red compared to this one. See, yung isa sa right side kasi parang bright red. And ito parang pale na medyo may pagka maroonish. Look at this way. Ito, pag nag-paint ka kasi ng red, direct sa primer, na walang base coat na white, parang ganito yung lalabas. And then, pag nag-base coat ka naman ng white, and then red, ganyan yung lalabas. So, ganun ko siya mako-compare. anyway, excuse me. Oh, I see the rifle here. Ito yung rifle. Very, very detailed din ang rifle niya. Napaganda sa pinturahan. But I would wish sana magkakaiwala yung ibang parts para mas madaling ma-paint at ma-detail. Still, malaki naman siya. Madaling mag-masking pag medyo malaki. Yan. At another white part sa legs. I think this is for the legs naman. I'm looking at this. Oh, I think akala ko ano to. Iwalay na part na green. It's built-in din pala. Two parts center left and right. Next! Napuno na kagad yung namesa natin. Ganun kadami runner. Ilan ba ito? 62 ba? 63 MB lang natin. I forgot na sa dami. Let's return this muna sa loob. And hindi na naman tayo sa left side. So, yun pa rin. Greenish. Oh, dalawa meron din pala dito sa part na to. At nakakita pa ako ng isang. Ay, ito pala! Okay, so yung kaninang pinuturo ko sa inyo sa may legs na nasa na tayo, hanapin natin dito. Nasa ilalim na, ito yung pinapatong doon. So, akala ko talaga green pa kasi ito, sorry, ito pala. So, parang ito yata yung pinapatong doon, para magmukha siyang green. So, I think merong ipapatong pa na sticker or water slide para ma-enhance pa yung color sa ilalim. So, at nakikita pa ang isang color, ang gray. So, meron pa siyang gray na part sa legs din yata to. Tama ba? Yan, mukha sa legs kasi or wait, o sa head. Or, I'm not sure. Kasi, ibang parts dito for the head eh. Like this one, ito sa head for sure, at this one as well. At yung face, that is the faceplate. At pinunagan natin, let's focus on that. So, one piece lang siya. So, medyo fragile yata to dahil yung pagkakadugtong nung sa gitna nung throw ng noo sa mukha is yun lang, yung part na yan. Let's look at the backside. So, yun. Ah, okay, so medyo maano naman pala. I think medyo matibay unless mapwersa siya. At, let's look at the other parts. Another block or runner for the tactical arms. This one as well. Some red parts. What's on a water slide? I'm not seeing any water slide. Nakaban ako. Sa ilalim. I do hope so, nasa ilan. Bakit walang water slide to? Ayun, ang paa. Ang feet niya. At ang backpack. For sure, this is for the backpack. Ayan. This one is for the upper body. So, right. Okay. Tama ba? Okay ba ba na? Oh wait, pareho lang pala ng tone ng red sa kanina. Kasi sabi ko na parang marunish na nail period ang dating niya. And ito yung mga polycaps pala guys. Okay. So it's also red. Oh no, it's not polycaps kasi it's hard. It's from the runner S. Oh wait, medyo malambot siya. It's really not that hard. So, but it's not that soft as well. So I'm not sure kung rubber to or semi-rubber siguro. Okay, at meron tayong chrome parts for the chrome parts for the pistons. They're usual. Lahat naman yata ng pistons is kino-chrome ni Bandai. At may detail ah. This is a first. Or hindi ko napansin. Usually sa mga chrome S runner to O naman. And at meron din siyang beam effect for the sword. So, bukod dun sa Gerber's Fate at Pierce, ano isa? Lightning Pierce na yun. Let me check nga ulit. Gusto kong malaman. Ano ba yan? Huwag nakakalimutan ko. Anyway, hold on guys. Ah, ito. Gerber's Fate at Tiger Pierce. Meron pa siyang beam. Beam sword. Beam katana sword. O, beam sword. Basta yun na yun. Basta beam yung ginagamit. Saling ayaw niya magkatana. Next are the manipulator hands. So it's white and red. It's white and red. I'm still not really a fan ng itong kamay. So natatakot ako. Mabali. At meron siyang kasamang knife. So, daggers. So, pagkakaalala ko, may ganito na si Strike na perfect grade. O, syempre, isa lang yung pinagkunan. Pareho lang siguro ng 2004, yes, tama. Because 2004 daw ba si Strike na PG. Just 2004. So, recolor lang. Next is some other white parts. What is this for? And this is for the not sure if it's for the elbows. And some gold plated parts for the sword. So pareho lang silang V. So isa lang yung ginamit ng Tiger Pierce at Gerber's Fate. It's gold plated as usual sa mga sword. Sa Master Grade, hindi ko alam if ganito rin. Pero parang may nakita ko gold. Plated din yata. And, mayroong pattern. Wow, it's a devil. And may horn. Same ba ng design? Oh wait, magkaiba ng design. Oh wait, pareho lang. Baliktad lang pala yung hawak ko sa isa. I'm sorry guys, pareho lang pala. Halo ko magkaiba. Yes, it is the same. Next, are the actual polycaps. Yes, it still has the polycaps pa rin na rubber. Ito na yung rubber. Kanina medyo matigas. Baka for stability yun, kaya ganun ginawa nila ganun. At yung mga metal parts. There are three. So, this one of each for left and right. And then, itong gitna. Okay, I think this is for the legs connector, no? Sa hip. Or sa waist niya. Connector na legs. Bakal. Parang mas tibay. Thank you, Bandai. Hindi ko maalala. Ganun dito sa slide. At wala pa rin tayo nakikita ang water slide. Up! Nakita na ako dito. Sa ilalim! Yan, hindi ako kinakabahan. Nakita ko na. Ito ulit is a runner for the for the legs. Those are very very nice details. And I think this is also the same runner from the Red Frame na lobas before 2004 ba? Yes, 2004. Oh, teka, 2004. Sa strike yun eh. Red Frame, do correct me guys, no? Parang 2008 yata lobas ang Red Frame eh. Astrike 2004. So, nakalimutan ko na. Pasensya. So, Ari Color, kasi siya, alam ko, pareho na kasi ang frame halos ng Red Frame at ng Strike. Do correct me if I'm wrong again. I'm not perfect, you know. 2004. And, what is this? Let's proceed to this one. 2009. Okay, so ito, this is for the ano na talaga. Red Frame na perfect grade. So, I think this is I think this is for the arms or legs. Dito kasi nalagay ng pistons eh. At ayun yung detail. At meron pa isang ayun na eh. Halo ko tuloy polycap. It's not polycap. It looks like polycaps but it is not dahil matigas. This is runner I. And buka nasa huli talaga ang water slide talaga pinapa-excite ng Bandai. Kaya tayo sa base. So I think this is a regular base. Wait, hindi siya regular base dahil siya ay pang perfect grade na base. Wow. Ito lang yata yung pinaka runner. It has three runners lang para sa base. So siya regular. Ang late lang ang base niya pang master grade. I wish Bandai could have used a much bigger base to. Kasi liit. Hindi talaga. For mass grade lang to for me. I think you would need another one. Para mas malating na. Dugtong yun na lang. And last and not but the least of the runners are this one. This is, I think this is another. Oh, dalawa. Dalawa ang blade effect niya. So, dalawang sword pa rin ang gagamitin niya. Pag nagsawa na siyang kakaswing ng dalawa niyang katana. This is, I think, for the legs part again. And the details. Siyempre, walang date eh. Pero I think this is from 2008 pa rin. Sa dating Astray Red Frame. At ayun na! Ayun na ang water slide na kasama ni Astray Red Frame guy. Wow, water slide. Ang dami. Gerber Astray at Tiger Pierce. So yan. May sarili silang decals na kasama. At may sticker pa rin para sa mata at sa head camera na green. So ang dami. Medyo madami siya. Dandanin natin yung camera para makita nyo. Ang ganda ng decals. Wow, speechless. Siyempre. Nag-water slide siya. Astray Red Frame Kai. So, I think yung Chinese character na yung talaga is Kai. Or Japanese character. I'm not sure. Do forgive me that. Hindi ko rin alam. And hidden structure bolts. See maintenance manual. Bakit mo nalagyan ng ganun? At makikita ng kalaban. So, ayan. And also, this one. Ito. Kailangan natin. Tiger Pierce at River Straight. I mean, naman, Astray Red Frame, malaki. nakalak may word dito eh. Nakasama. So wala pa lang talaga. It's just, I think it's just a design. But may letter eh. N-V-W-F-S-N. S-M. Not sure kung anong huli. So kung ano ibig sabihin yan, kindly inform us sa video. Pakicomment na lang kung ano ibig sabihin itong A-V-W-F-S-M reverse triangle. O delta, baka delta yan. Kasi may reverse triangle kanina. Ito, makita ba natin? Nakasulat. Warning! Teka, hindi natin mag-macro. Warning, look the patch memo. Hindi ko na mabasahin, masakit sa mata. Yun! Ang pinaka-highlight ng ating unboxing. Grabe to si Bandai. Talagang hinuli yung water slide. Tingnan mo nga naman. So, ayan yung mess na nangyari sa table natin. Sa dami ng kanyang runners. Oh my God, 60 plus runners. Hindi ko talaga in-expect na ganun kadami yung runners niya. Whew. Okay, so, kung wala pa itong ganda na to, I would highly suggest getting one. At napaka-ganda niya. To be honest, no? Ang ganda niya. Box pa lang kasi talaga eh, parang pang collector siya eh. Siguro if this is mine, I would not assemble this one. Sa totoo lang. Yan na. Sorry. Ang bigat ng box. Hindi ko siya i-assemble. Lalagay ko siya sa box. Kasi for me, it looks like for collection lang. Sa akin ha. But if you want to build it, do share your photos sa YouTube. Pwede ba mag-share ng photos sa YouTube? I'm not sure. But if pwede, at may naka-built na kayo, kindly share with us. At also, pwede nyo palang i-share dito sa ating Facebook page sa Wasabi Toys. Facebook, Wasabi Cats. Yan, Wasabi Cats yung name natin. Still, we are Wasabi Toys pa rin, no? Wasabi Cats kasi we are like cats na naghanap ng Gundam sa Wasabi Toys. Pag nasa loob, parang gusto natin bilhin lahat. That is why we are called Wasabi Cats. So, yan. So, for stocks and availability, kindly check our website at wasabitoys.com at sa Facebook page natin, we always provide updates pala sa stocks natin sa shop. Tomorrow is Sunday, I'll be posting some new stocks, so I'll try to go to the shop para ting kuna na video ating mga friends doon at yung mga stocks natin. Dahil alam nyo na, it's sa COVID, napaka really hit us hard at kailangan natin mag ingat. Still, I would try to go, no? Gusto ko rin siya mag-shoot ng video doon. To be honest, gusto ko doon mag-unbox sa shop, sa actual shop natin. Kaso, minsan kasi, pag nandun tayo, busy rin yung mga friends natin, nagpa-pack ng mga orders nyo. But, one of these days, I'll make a unboxing video sa shop natin. Until then, I hope na gustuhan nyo ang ating unboxing video for this kick tit guy na is actually one hell of a kit to have, no? Oo nga pala guys, ito yung aking display stand. Wala na ako masyadong gunpla dahil nasa Green Hills na. Wala man na lang yan ay some random PG ARF 17 na lang siya. Ghost Rider Josh Aquino, shout out, nandiyan pa rin yung kit mo sa akin. Si Ryoko, yan guys. If you have not seen Tenshi Muyo, that is Tenshi, this is Ryoko, my favorite anime characters of all time, and those trophies are not mine. Anyway, yun ang ating unboxing video na picture sa ating studying workshop. Well, it's not a workshop anymore because I don't have time to build na. Still, I am doing my best. At may nakano pa tayong Deep Striker, hindi pa tapos. Until next time, if you have kits na gusto nyong ipa-unbox, do inform us, comment na kayo sa video natin at sa ating Facebook page sa Wasabi Cats or Wasabi Toys. Also, you can visit our Shopee page. Shopee, Wasabi Toys, yung pwede kayo mag-order. At ang ating website, again, that is wasabitoys.com for stocks and availability. Yan akong boses. Again, mag-ingat tayo guys. Keep safe, keep healthy. Mask on, don't mask off. Drink your vitamins. Till our next unboxing video. keep safe. This is Dre, Team Basic Compla, and now Wasabi Toys. Good.